So we are gonna talk about version control system, what they are. Specifically, we're gonna look at a version control system called Git. These slides are not mine. I found these on the internet. So just Google Git tutorial. The first couple of links will lead you to these slides. So actually, I planned for a tutorial earlier, but there is some problem with a VGA connector. So the tutorial is not going to be there. I'll give you an overview of what Git and GitHub is, how does it work, and why version control is important, all these sort of things. By the way, how many of you have already used this kind of thing like SVN, Git, GitHub before? A lot of you. Cool. So basically, while you guys will start working, you'll need some version control system in order to sync your project across all the developers. So you'll install Git. There are other version control systems as well, but we are going to use Git. GitHub is basically a service which hosts your repositories, which hosts your code. So basically, version control is something which keeps track of your code. So if four people are working across a project and four people are situated at different places, there is a huge problem in syncing your code. Yeah. So using version control systems, we basically sync our code, keep track of our code. We can roll back to the previous stable state. We can add more commits, all these sort of things. These commits, staging area, all these things, all these terms which I'm saying, we're gonna look at what these things are. So Git is basically a distributed version control system created by Linus Torvalds, the Linux founder. What happens is you work on your local repository, make all the changes, commit your changes, and then you push your changes to the remote server so that everyone will be able to see. And how you do it is internally managed by Git so that everyone is on the same page, everyone has the same code, and there are no there is no in sync changes. So there are other version control systems as well, like Subversion, Purpose, there is Tortoise, SVN also, but like Git is like sort of the most popular stuff. So basically what we are going to do during the course of this summer internship is you're gonna create one repository for your project on GitHub. You're gonna clone it. Clone it basically means copying it to your local directory. You're gonna start working in your local directory, add all the changes that you are doing on a daily basis, and then push your code on a daily basis. So when I say I commit my code, I basically mean I am creating a snapshot of what I have right now. A snapshot is basically the state of project right now. So let's say I just created an empty folder. I created one file in it which just prints hello world, nothing else. So here, this hello world, this one file is the first change I did in my project. How others are going to know that I have made this change is I'm gonna commit these changes in my local repository first, then I'm gonna push these changes to a remote server. So all this process is called committing. Like you are committing your code, you're making your code final. So commits are basically maintained in a sort of linked list sort of structure. So after one commit, there will be another commit, another commit, another commit, and each commit will point to its parent commit. Repositories, as I have said, is just your project directories. So what happens is, first you create your repo on the GitHub, and then you're gonna clone that repo. By cloning, I mean you make a local copy of your repository on your laptops. You will start working from that. Okay, another thing is pulling and pushing. So pulling changes means suppose you are working on one file, another person is working on some another file or the same file, some other different portions of the same file. So once you start working, before you start working, you pull the changes of all the people, then you start writing your code so that your repository will be in sync. Another thing is, after you make all the changes, you are sure that your changes are fine, it is working, and after you commit your code, you push all these changes to a remote server. Branches. So the general convention is to use different branches for different features. The main branch is called the master branch. I mean, you can name it anything else, but then people use this name master. This is basically the stable branch which works. Another branch can be a development branch, can be another feature branch, so that you just create a new feature, add a branch. After you are sure that it is working fine, you just merge it into the master branch. So this is how your project is going to look like. Basically a directory where all your code will be there and a bunch of commits. So as I've said, commits are nothing but sort of a linked list kind of structure. So this commit is pointing to its parent commit, this commit is pointing to its parent commit, this commit is pointing to its parent commit, and currently you are here. So head determines the position where you are actually right now, and master is basically the branch name. So you are at the head of your master branch. Yeah, so as I have said, the main branch is called master, but this is just a convention. You can almost name it anything else. So if you want to add new features, you're just gonna create a new feature branch, code all your changes that you want to incorporate in your feature, and then there is something called as pull request. You create a pull request from your feature branch. If the code gets verified, it is working fine, then your feature will be merged into the master branch. So all this merging process, this happens through something called as pull request. Initially we thought of giving you a demo of all that, but then that is not happening right now. So we'll see if sometime in the future we can do all these things. So suppose your project is here right now, and from here you decided to create a new feature. So you'll create a new branch called a feature branch. You'll start working on your feature, and meanwhile the master some other features will be getting merged into the master branch. So the master branch will keep on moving forward. And after this commit, let's say you realize that your feature is complete, it is working fine. So after you reach this point, after you commit all your changes, from here you will create a pull request, and if it gets verified, it gets merged into the master branch. Yeah, so your master branch was here earlier, and if all these things gets verified, this will be merged. So the local copies of your project in your laptops, in your desktops, is basically called as working directory. After you make changes, you need to move your files to the staging area before you can push them to the remote server. So this intermediate layer is called the staging area, where you add all those files using git add. So all these files will move to staging area. Then after that, you commit your changes. So these commits will be in your local repository after this step, and then after that you can push to the remote server. So as I said, you use the command git add to put all your files into the staging area, and then after that you use git commit to commit your new changes. And every commit has a specific message regarding what this commit is doing, like what changes this commit is making. So this is your working directory. After you make all the changes, you move your files to the staging area, and after that you commit the changes, and then this structure moves forward. You are here, right? So after you put your files to staging area, and after you commit the changes, your head will also move forward, because head always points to the latest commit. So what is GitHub? GitHub is basically a service which allows you to host your repositories. So it has a very good bug tracking system, issue tracking system. So what we are going to do is we are going to follow like issue driven development sort of stuff. What basically issue driven development means is, before you start writing code, you create one issue which describes whatever you are going to do. So even before you start writing a function that just prints hello world, you're gonna create one issue on GitHub which says this function is needed which prints hello world, and your code will correspond to this issue. So every time you push your changes, you know that which issue you are tracking, which feature you are tracking right now. Yeah, apart from all this stuff, there is one very short course on Udacity. So people who are like completely new to version control, completely new to what Git and GitHub is, just search for a course on Udacity. Just type Git course, Udacity course or something like that. It's a very short course. You can probably finish it in 5-6 hours, but it gives you like all the details. I've talked about Git and GitHub on like very basic level. There are something called as merge conflicts, there is something called as rebasing. All these things will be available in detail in that course. Like over the course of time, you'll know how these things are done. Yeah, that's it.